Man, I'm always hooking drum in the holes. On red again. Big. Yeah. Trying to keep him out of that fast water. Oh. He's a fighter. That's a nice one. Dude, right in the asshole. Damn. That's right in his asshole. Oh. He ain't gonna poop right for a while. Not for sure, but I think the water might be decreasing. Oh, man. Alright, a few more casts and I gotta go. So, down here fishing in, you know it's cold when that's happening. Oh,
what the.
It's little. Look out. No. Come on. Let's try this. He's not hooked. Shouldn't be.
There he goes.
I just seen this old man that I keep running into, and he just had a huge stringer of some pretty decent crappie, couple of walleye, trying to get him to bite on this swim bait. But I've been coming down here on Saturday and Sunday in the evenings. I've caught a few small ones. We're letting out a lot of water, and they turned it off last weekend. And supposedly they caught a bunch of them in the 6 to 7 pound range, walleye that is. How does that even work? I was down here last weekend, a guy came down here and caught one that was probably about 5 pounds on his second cast. But everyone's been using smaller plastics than this guy. But I'm also secretly fishing for flathead, which I also know doesn't make sense this time of year, but it's a personal goal of mine, a winter flathead on a swim bait. It's a channel cat. That's not a bad catch. There we go. I'll take it. I have recently put fluorocarbon on a couple of my reels, and I don't really have a whole lot of experience with it. Normally the only time I'd use it is with like 4 pound test for trout or something in real clear water. I have to say that I like that little extra stretch. I could feel it on that catfish just a little bit. I could see where it would come in handy, but it's still not fun when you get snagged up in the rocks and you're trying to get your lure out and all it does is stretch. Walleye and catfish are pretty much back to back within a couple casts. And I snagged into something else. Who knows? There's Asian carp in here. Now, that's not what I was looking for. Thinking I'm gonna move down a little bit. Oh man, if I quit talking, I'd probably catch more fish. I think I'm gonna move locations down. This local fisherman that I talked to when I'm down here had that giant stringer and he caught him down just a little ways. But I have a feeling there'll probably be people down there, which isn't my favorite. But we shall see. I've never been to this spot before, and I believe where I'm supposed to be going down is right over there, but there are a lot of vehicles down there. So I'm gonna come in from a distance and see, scope it out, see how it looks. My main goal is just to find potential. I'm not really expecting to catch a whole lot these days. there might be a lot of people on this side. And I can see a land bridge on the other side of this cliff. Oh, the things I do to get to a fishing spot. Well, that's worth a look. I'm out here fishing a local Kansas reservoir. Originally trying to catch some flathead with swim baits. That turned into walleye. And then today turned into crappie. Pretty cool little location. Little waterfall at the end of a spillway. I'm hoping that some sauger or walleye will start biting, but it started raining mid-afternoon, turned the water to mud. See how it goes. Hey, he hit on the black and white one. I was thinking about taking that off. And the top one. You got it? I think he wants yours too. The elusive wall. Hey, they do this every time. Let go. Yeah, let go. Let us do this number. Coming at me, maybe. Contemplating bringing that stuff over here. What's up? Almost, maybe. Hit myself with that one, Dad. Yeah, I'm not complaining at all. Yeah. Oop, there's another bite. Take it. Yeah. They've been hitting both colors though. What's up?
Seen it yet?
No, I think I snagged it though. Wiper. I think it's a crappie. Whoa. My drag, I think, got water in it.
Another species.
Black and chartreuse. That's all right. Yeah. Oh. Ugh. Still need him.